Let's talk about the EA servers. Let's go.
The power of the dark side.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, my name is Psychosis169 and I bring you FIFA 18 content, mostly focused on Ultimate Team, but I do speak about other FIFA issues as well. And today I'm having a little rant on the EA servers. I know you guys all hate it and I know everybody's keeping quiet about it, but today I'm talking about it. Intermittently in the video, you'll see me have a little stress episode, if I may call it that. If you are new here, please consider subscribing if you are interested in more FIFA 18 content. The following event took place 2 weeks ago. Yo boys, did you guys get FIFA 18? So we're not sleeping tonight, we are playing FIFA the entire night. I've got some snacks, I've got my KFC sorted, cool drink, staying hydrated tonight, we're not sleeping at all. Let's go boys, FIFA 18, yeah, come on!
2 hours later.
And the servers are still down. To only play 2 matches of pro clubs, how bloody disappointing. So we are in South Africa and trying to find matches in pro clubs has been absolutely impossible. Ultimate Team has been stable and I wonder why that is. Oh wait, because Ultimate Team actually makes money for EA. That's why Ultimate Team can be more stable. We can't find matches in pro clubs. We will sit every night for about 5 hours trying to find matches in pro clubs, but guess what? No matches. And it only matches up to local guys. Why can't I change my approximate location setting, which I did to know, and find international people to play with? If my internet connection is shit, then why don't you have that little bar you have on Ultimate Team, the latency bar, and allow us to choose our opponents. Show the latency on the game. It's not that difficult. Let me just go off on a different tangent here. Why can't pro clubs be EA Sports' eSports mode? Why does that have to be Ultimate Team? Football is a team sport and pro clubs is team game mode. So why not make it pro clubs and not Ultimate Team? Wait, let me get back to you on that one. Because Ultimate Teams makes more money for EA. And what is this thing on Ultimate Team where you go onto the market and you try and search for a player and the player is like 48 minutes into selling and you can't buy the player? Then you go back out, you go back in, the same player pops up, you try to buy the player again and the player is still on the market. I am sure EA can fix this problem. When a player is bought, it should automatically, immediately disappear off the transfer market. How bloody simple is that? Waste so much of our time trying to find players. How much money does EA make every year? EA makes around $650 million every year from Ultimate Team alone. Do you not think some of that $650 million can go into getting some better servers? Oh wait, how do I know they've got bad servers? Just give me a second. I've got a little sample of how EA works on FIFA release day. Yes, sir. Yes. I will let the servers go live now. We are good to go. EA servers. Dude, and like, they know how many people are going to buy their game every year, or they can at least estimate. They are a big, huge company that make millions of dollars every year. Why can they not sort their servers out? Why do we have to sit on the first night of FIFA release? I had a tough day at work. I had a rough day with the kids. And then I just want to chill. I just want to relax and play some pro clubs with my friends or even some Ultimate Team. And then EA can't even deliver that. Let me sketch a scenario for you. If you wanted a new phone and this phone had a new feature, say it's facial recognition, and you go and you go get that brand new phone and you get home and the phone's facial recognition feature doesn't work. you would be pissed off, right? You'd be pissed off. You take that phone right back. So why don't we, as EA consumers, take the bloody game right back? Because there is no other decent football games in the world. Hashtag sorry, Pro Evolution. Let's just quickly talk about Weekend League. Button delay. This is supposed to be a professional mode in FIFA that can qualify you to regionals or to the FIFA Interactive World Cup, but you still get button delay. What the hell is that? Like, seriously, sort the servers out. Oh, wait, even better, if you don't want our South African money, we've been paying so much money for the game, then don't ship the game to South Africa. Wait. Yeah, I retract that statement. Please do still ship the game to South Africa, but just fix the servers. So, boys, thank you so much for watching. That is the end of me and my potato. If you like this video, remember to hit that like button down below. And please, if you are new here, consider subscribing. This is your boy, Psychosis169, signing out. Cheers. Stay psyched.